Hi everyone! In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to reproduce this colorful, minimalist poster design. We'll start with an image of a cyborg woman and create a visual that blends it with typography and a burnt paper effect. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and leave a like. It will motivate me to create and share other creations. We'll start by opening Photoshop with a rectangular work surface. You can start with an A3 format if you like. Then I'll apply a black background. We'll import the image of our main subject. I'll take care of removing the background from the image. To do this, as our background is a solid color, I'll go to the Selection tab and click on Color Range. This will open a new panel and we'll select the color of our background. We can manage the intensity of the selection on this new panel. Once we're happy with our selection, we'll validate it. Then we'll right-click and select Invert, and click on the little icon at bottom right to apply a mask of our selection to our layer. As the color we chose was also on our main subject, there will be some holes. So I'll simply repaint the mask on my layer with my brush tool in white. Once my mask has been reworked, we'll replace our character. From here on in, we'll take care of our color. We can easily give a visual a colorful appearance by using the Gradient Map option found in the Adjustments tab. This option converts the light intensity of our layers into a color gradient. To adjust this gradient, we click on our Gradient Map layer and click on the gradient. A Gradient Editor panel will open, from which we can define the colors of our visual. To change a color, simply click on the small color square below the gradient bar. This will open the Color Picker panel, where you can choose the color you want. To add a color, click below the gradient bar where you wish to add it. We can also move our colors on our gradient by dragging the little color squares. To create a beautiful gradient, start with the darkest color and end with the lightest. Once we've defined the color of our visual, we can work on the background of our poster. We'll add a new layer and then I'll simply use the brush tool, reducing the hardness parameter and increasing its size value. By choosing a white color, we'll be able to create a gradient easily, as we have a black background and our brush generates a diffuse white line. We just need to reposition our white gradient layer as we wish. I'm going to repeat the same process but with a black brush to darken certain areas. Let's rework the details of our cyborg woman. To do this, I'll go to the Filter tab and choose the Camera Raw Filter option. In the panel that just opened, we'll start by configuring some options in the Basics tab. I'm going to increase the texture and clarity values, which will enhance the details of my image. I'll accentuate my image by increasing the values of blacks and whites, and reducing those of shadows and contrast. Finally, I'll increase vibrance to accentuate color intensity. When it's okay for me, I validate. I'm going to rework this effect again, as I don't want it to be applied everywhere on my character, only on the cybernetic part. To do this, I'll click on the mask of my effect and use the black brush tool to erase the areas I don't want to keep. I'll make my image stand out a little more by opening the Layer Style panel simply by double-clicking on my layer. Once in this panel, I'll add the Bevel and Emboss effect. I'll apply the following parameters: Style, Selects, Inner Bevel, Technique, Select, Smooth. Check that the other parameters are similar. Then adjust your angle as you wish. This will redefine the angle of the contour light in your image. we're going to concentrate on the text part of our poster. To do this, I'm going to use Adobe Illustrator. Once I'm on my work plan, I'll add my text. I'm going to choose a thick, long basic typeface. Once I've done that, I'll right-click and choose the Vectorize option, which will transform our text into a vector shape. We'll simply distort the letters by selecting them and stretching them as we wish. We'll import our text by simply copying and pasting it into Photoshop. I'm going to duplicate the black gradient layer I created earlier to make it go over my text. With Ctrl plus T, I'll resize and position my black gradient as I wish. Then, by right-clicking on this layer, I'll apply the clipping mask option to incorporate my gradient into my text. We're going to add a shadow to wear under our character. To do this, I'm going to create a new layer, and by Ctrl plus left clicking on the image of my layer, I'll be able to retrieve a selection of what my layer contains. Then I'll fill my selection with black. I'll double click on my layer to open the Layer Style panel and add a drop shadow. In this interface, we'll be able to configure our shadow as we wish. I'll accentuate our main subject by adding a brightness contrast effect layer and applying a clipping mask so that it only applies to my layer. I'll add some text at the very top of my visual to add some meaning to the poster. We're going to add an outline to our text, so we'll duplicate our text layer. I'm going to do a Ctrl plus left click on the image of the character layer to be able to retrieve the selection of what my layer contains. Then I'll right click on my working plane and choose Select Invert to create a mask of my selection. I'll reduce my layer's fill option to 0%, which will make it transparent. Then I'll double click on it to open the Layer Style panel and add the Stroke option. I'll configure it so that its position is outside and white in color, so I can manage its thickness as I see fit. Once that's okay, I'll import an organic shape I've made myself. If you'd like to make your own, I invite you to follow my video tutorial on my channel, or you can download 30 vector shapes for free. The link is in the description. I'm going to place my layer below my cyborg woman and change her blending style. To do this, go here, and I'll choose Soft Light. This blends my shape more diffusely so that it blends in better with my visual. This will add a little detail to the background of my poster. To add a little depth, I decided to add a drop shadow to my text. I'll double-click on it to open the Layer Style panel and add the Drop Shadow option, which I'll set as I wish. I'll repeat the same operation on my other text layer. For my part, I feel I've finished with the overall composition of my poster design. I'll now go to FX and add texture to my visual to make it more realistic. If you're interested in texture packs, you can find them for free on my online store. The link is in the description. I'll start by integrating a black crumpled fabric texture, to which I'll apply the Color Dodge blend mode and reduce its fill value. This will leave only the white weft of my texture. I'll accentuate our rendering by adding a brightness contrast effect layer and reworking these parameters. Then I'll import a plastic texture on top and place it. To finish with my textures, I'll import a final plastic texture, this one more crumpled. I'll position it and move its layer under my main subject to provide a background texture and detach my elements. As of now, I think I'm done with my artwork. Let's move on to the final rendering, reworking the colors and other visual effects. We'll start by selecting all our layers and putting them in a group. Then we'll right-click on this group and convert it into a smart object. We'll press Ctrl plus A to select our working plane and copy and paste to duplicate it. We'll convert this new layer back into a smart object. Then go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. From here, we'll have the choice of resetting the rendering of our visual. It's up to you to configure it as you like. I advise you to add a little grain to your rendering. Also work on the vignetting option, which will create shading around the visual, centering the eye on the center of the poster. Once you're happy with your retouching, all that's left is to validate it. The beauty of using smart objects is that we can double-click on them to return to our effects and reshape them. We're going to finish the rendering of our visual by adding a touch of originality to our poster. To do this, I'm going to convert this last layer into a smart object, and we're going to open a new work surface in square format. I'll transform the background of my work surface into black and then import my poster. I'll also import a burnt paper texture. This texture is available in my burnt texture pack on my online store. We'll reposition it so that it's the same width as the layer below. I'll turn off the layers below my texture and go to the Select tab and Color range. From here, I'll select the burnt part of my paper and validate. Then I'll create a mask on this layer with my new selection. As you can see, my selection has created areas of transparency in places. To remedy this, we'll simply duplicate our layer several times, select them and convert them into a smart object. Then I'll add a mask to my texture layer and use a brush to erase any excess areas. I'll reposition my layer to fit my poster underneath. On my poster layer, I'll add a mask. Then, Ctrl plus left click on the image of my texture layer to retrieve its selection area. Right click and select invert. Back in the mask of my visual layer, I'll use a brush to erase any overlapping areas. Finally, we'll duplicate the burnt paper texture layer and apply the soft light blend mode, which will accentuate our texture. And here's the final result. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. I'll be delighted to help you. If you liked this video, please subscribe and leave a like. It will motivate me to create more tutorials of my creations. See you on the channel.